Welcome to the regular update from Dartmouth-Hitchcock. I'm Ed Merrens, the Chief Clinical Officer.
And I'm Antonia Altomare, the Hospital Epidemiologist. We have one update for you since our last video, and that is that New Hampshire had announced a fifth case of COVID-19. This occurred in the southern region of the state, and I think there's good understanding that this was from the Massachusetts cluster we are seeing, but we have no new cases to report related to our Upper Valley cluster of cases.
Another update is, as we begin to make recommendations for gatherings and social distancing across our organization, we've decided that the Battle of the Badges hockey game, which is to benefit our children's hospital at Dartmouth, will be an event that continues to play out with the hockey teams, but will be without spectators. We're fortunate that this will be able to be streamed live on WMUR.com. And that these teams can meet each other, but we're responding like a lot of other organizations, college sport teams, and actually professional teams are as it relates to holding sporting events but without spectators. Again, we're doing this out of an abundance of caution for the community, the spectators, and our patients. We've had a number of questions about how we keep our place clean and what you can expect when you come to Dartmouth-Hitchcock or one of our member hospitals. Remember, we have member hospitals across both New Hampshire and Vermont and a large community group practice in southern New Hampshire. The good news is that we've always been keeping our places extraordinarily clean, and the products that we use actually kill viruses. This is in the clinical environment where you might see your doctor or your nurse or nurse practitioner that sees you or your family, but also in the public areas as well. And these have been kept clean for a long time. We are clearly understand people's concerns, but want to reassure you that when you come here, the environment that you will experience will be clean. In addition, there's ample opportunities for you to keep your hands clean at any of our facilities or member hospitals. We have hundreds, maybe even more, stations with alcohol dispensing with gel that you can clean your hands with as you enter the facility and at all our clinic sites. We should talk a little bit, though, about what you can continue to do at home as you travel and as you work.
So in the spirit of respiratory season, it's always good to keep your environment clean as well. This means your environment at home, your car, or wherever you may frequent. And this can simply be done with routine cleaning solutions at home. Some of the hot spots to clean would be things like doorknobs and light switches or computer keyboards and cell phones. It's always a good idea to do your countertops and your bathrooms. And also remember to wash your hands. Soap and water or alcohol-based hand rubs are equally effective.
The other thing just about these briefings and our regular updates is that we're working to have all of them have closed captioning for those that rely on that to understand and receive our message just as well as everyone else. This takes time for us to be able to do this, but you can expect this with this and our other communications on a regular basis. We really appreciate your questions. We're incorporating them into these updates, and we'll be coming back on a regular basis to share more. As always, you can reach out to us at social@hitchcock.org. We have a staffed hotline at 603-650-1818 or at any time at dh.org.